It's an honor to be speaking here on a day of such strong and popular uprising internationally. The geopolitical status quo in the Middle East is undergoing a dramatic shake-up, and as the Arab peoples take to the streets and demand their democratic rights in popular uprisings. Recognizing the Palestinian people as an important constituent part of the Arab world, the Ireland-Palestine Solidarity Campaign salutes these popular manifestations of a desire for a truly democratic Middle East, free from the meddling of outside interests, where people control their own national identities. For a Palestinian solidarity movement, it is important to recognize that the events in Egypt, in particular, could have important repercussions for the Palestinian National Liberation Movement. Since the signing of the Camp David Accords between Egypt and Israel in 1978, the Egyptian state has developed even closer ties with its Israeli neighbor, culminating in its shameful complicity in the ongoing siege of Gaza. The resignation of President Mubarak could potentially result in a substantial change in diplomatic relations, depriving Israel of its vital regional ally. It is clear that the Palestinian struggle for their human, civil, democratic and national rights is widely supported by the people of Egypt and by the Arab public opinion in general. And it is to be hoped that any future government coming to power in Egypt will reflect that support in its actions as well as in its rhetoric. The Israeli response to these uprisings has been interesting, to say the least. Israeli officials have been quick to recognize that these momentous events could have serious repercussions with regard to regional cooperation with their apartheid regime. To paraphrase an Israeli minister, a democratic Arab world would end intelligence and security coordination between Israel and various Arab states, because a democratic system would be governed by a public generally opposed to Israeli state policies. Showing clearly whose side they stand on, Israel has called on the US and the EU to curb their already mild criticisms of Mubarak in the interest of quote-unquote stability. Perhaps the Israeli view on democracy in the Middle East was best and most clearly made apparent by the Israeli minister, who told Time magazine that he was not sure that the time was right for the Arab region to go through the democratic process. There is no doubt, despite its oft-repeated and utterly false mantra, that it is the only democracy in the Middle East, that Israel fears a democratic Middle East, while developments in that direction can only have a positive impact on the Palestinian struggle. As the Israeli journalist Gideon Levy succinctly put it, as long as the masses in Egypt...
You need to go for us at the embassy and know what's up there. We need the embassy.
Okay, well,